A lot of us have been so sick with this. We all know that there are other allergens, though, that can make us sick as well.
Yeah, you've been sniffling a little bit,
I think, with your own.
The hard part is figuring out exactly what you're allergic to. Now, Dr. Joe's here with a new way to test that some say is easier and less painful, Joe.
Well, Chip, right now it's a process of elimination. We typically order a battery of tests scratching your skin with different allergens to find out which affects you. But there is another option. Some say diagnosing your allergy could be as simple as a blood test.
You're gonna get a cold.
When it comes to singing, the 7-year-old is anything but shy.
Don't say
But thanks to allergies, keeping Sydney's pipes in pitch hasn't been easy.
It was really the stuffy nose and the watery eyes that were really bothering her.
And then she got a rash.
Her arms, chest, neck.
They were like, I had bunches of bug bites.
And she was just miserable.
Instead of the standard skin test for allergies, Jennifer's mom chose a different option. It's called ImmunoCAP. It starts with a blood draw.
We can take a look at airborne disease, you know, the grasses, molds, trees, pollens, weeds, dust, that kind of thing that's common. But we also can take a look at foods and the food reactions we can look at with this blood test that you can't do with the skin testing.
Dr. Leonard Rubenstein believes those delayed food reactions cause more than just a runny nose.
We're finding out that things like rheumatoid arthritis and chronic inflammatory diseases and chronic fatigue and fibromyalgia, a lot of issues that maybe patients wouldn't recognize as being allergic source are being found to be allergically based.
There's no evidence that allergies cause fibromyalgia. There's no evidence that allergies cause any of these other syndromes.
And while Dr. Richard Locke, president of the World Allergy Organization, agrees the ImmunoCAP test is accurate, he's concerned about how some of its results, called IgG4, are being interpreted.
In fact, there's no scientific evidence that means anything as far as an allergic patient goes.
Sydney's blood test showed reactions to things in the air and on the dinner table.
Bananas, oranges, broccoli.
Dr. Rubenstein recommended a rotating diet and allergy drops.
As you can see right now, there's no rashes, no watery eyes, no stuffy nose, nothing.
Bittersweet for Sydney, who can now eat everything.
Now I have to eat my Brussels sprouts.
Well, depending on which tests are ordered, the ImmunoCAP can cost $2,000 or $3,000. Insurance often covers a portion of that cost. Now, as for the allergy drops, most insurance companies do cover the shots, but not the drops. We have more information on our website, myfoxtampabay.com.